This particular project and topic is looking at high sensitivity troponin, which has just been rolled out in the United States at a few institutions. So it's an assay that's much more sensitive to detect myocardial infarction or a heart attack, but hasn't been FDA approved up until more recently here in the US. So has been available in Europe, Australia, and Canada for quite a while. Duke in particular has just rolled out this particular assay for myocardial infarction. And so we wanted to sort of review the upside and the downside of the assay for clinicians. The algorithms or the protocols for high sensitivity troponin are much quicker. So typically when you would come into the emergency department with chest pain, in order to be ruled out or to be told that you haven't had a heart attack, could take up to 12 hours once you were trending the various labs for conventional troponin. But now with high sensitivity troponin, we have much more accelerated protocols. So you can be ruled out or told that you haven't had a heart attack within a matter of a couple hours. The potential benefits would be that you can let patients go much more quickly, so the length of stay decreases by hours. Therefore, the cost of the hospitalization can decrease overall, the cost to the health system. It can decrease our utilization of invasive tests like cath in patients that are going to have normal vessels. So I think the upside is tremendous. We have quite a bit of evidence here in the United States that specifically in our observation unit. So if a patient comes in and you want to observe them over 24 hours just to make sure that they don't have any recurrent chest pain, that they may not have a heart attack, you put them in an observation unit. And at places like Duke and major medical centers, those observation units are crowded and oftentimes at full capacity. What the benefit of high sensitivity troponin is that you rule out people so quickly that you make it unnecessary to send them many of the times to these observation units. Many institutions have to figure out how to incorporate this assay into their electronic medical record. And so some of this discussion in this particular talk demonstrates how we did that here at Duke. So we were one of the first institutions really in the world to ever incorporate high sensitivity troponin into Epic or into MaestroCare, which is our electronic medical record. So it's expected that now that we've gone through this process, it may be easier for other institutions that have Epic to implement this assay or high sensitivity troponin at their institution. Anytime you have accelerated pathways like this, I think that makes people take pause that you could be potentially missing patients that have had a heart attack and be discharging them home. We know these assays, though, are much more sensitive to pick up any sort of elevation in troponin leak in a normal healthy person within several hours. So quite safe, quite specific, quite sensitive, so safe for picking up heart attacks very quickly. The implications, I think, are just widespread to both the patient, the health system, and to the clinician.